God can do anything and everything but faith. Amen. There's a sweet spirit is in this place, and I know it is the spirit of the Lord. For my testimony this morning, if it had not been for the Lord on our side, that somebody tell me, where would I be? Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise in this building. He's worthy to be praised. Come on, we can do better than that. Been almost 14 or 15 months on lockdown, locked in, locked out. But now you're back in the house of the Lord. I used to read some of your comments on Facebook. You said, I can't wait to get back in church. If you can't wait, act like you can't wait. Act like you're glad to be in here. Act like you want to praise Him. Act like you're thankful. Put those hands together. Open up your mouth all over this place and give God the praise and the glory. Because He's worthy to be praised. Let us stand at this time. Let us stand at this time. Reverend Freddie Smith, I want to flip the script. I want you to do the altar prayer for us this morning. Since today is Mother's Day, I'm asking that one of our mothers of the church, Deaconess Flores, who's president of our missionary society, will come and lead us in prayer at this time. Amen. We want her to pray before she board that flight Tuesday going to Texas. Amen. We want to hear from the president of our missionary society right now. And Reverend Freddie Smith will give us an altar prayer as he prayed for all mothers. This is the president of our missionary society. Amen. Our granddaughter is getting ready to receive a master's angel who worshiped with us for so much of the time when she was here. And Deaconess Flores is traveling out to be with the family. We're praying for traveling grace. We're praying for your safety, amen. And thank you for all the work that you do to advance the kingdom here at the Central Missionary Baptist Church. Pray good, Deaconess.
Amen. Good morning, Central. Our Father, we come to Thee once more and again, thanking You for all Your many blessings. But first, Lord, I want to say thank You for last night's sleep. You watched over us while we slumbered and slept. You didn't let no hurt, harm, or danger come upon us. And we just want to say thank You, Lord.
Thank You, Lord.
Early this morning, You woke us with a finger of love to a new day. And Father, when we woke, we had the activities, our limbs, our sight to see, but we was in our right mind.
Yes, Lord.
Thank You, Lord.
Thank You.
Father, we just want to say thank You for another day.
Thank You, God.
Thank You for being able to come out to the house of worship one more time.
Yes, Lord.
You know, Heavenly Father, if we had 10,000 tongues, we couldn't thank You enough for all that You've done for us. We thank You for what You've already done.
Yes,
we thank You what You're doing, and we thank You what You're still going to do.
Yes, God.
Oh, Heavenly Father, I come, Lord, asking You to bless Thee out Your people, oh Lord.
Yes, God.
And Father, we ask Thee to have mercy on. Oh, Heavenly Father, we just thank You for Your love and Your grace and Your mercy that allowed us to just say thank You, Lord. Because it could be, we wouldn't be able to say a word.
Yes,
and I just want to say thank You while the blood's running warm in my blood.
All right.
Because You didn't have to do nothing for any of us, but You did. Oh, Heavenly Father, as we continue this COVID, oh Lord, we ask You to be with us, Father.
Yes, God.
Lord, there's so many who have gone on. But we asking You, Lord, to still be with us. Protect us, Lord. Watch over us. We thank You, Lord.
Yes, God.
And oh, Heavenly Father, not for long, pray, but just want to say thank You for being in the house of the Lord. Just one more day. Thank You, Lord.
Thank You, God.
Thank You, Jesus.
Thank You.
And oh, Heavenly Father, as we continue these services, oh Lord, we ask Thee, Father, to be with us. Keep us in Your loving care. Bless our pastor, his family. Bless all our congregation.
Yes.
All our sick and shut-in members. We ask, bless, Lord, and be with them. These blessings, Lord, I ask in Your name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank You, Lord.
Amen.
be seated. We thank God for the spirit and the strength of our morning's prayer by Deaconess Margaret Flores, the president of Missionary Society here at the Central Baptist Church. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. There's a spirit of worship in this house on this morning, and we praise God in advance. Let us take this time now, my brothers and sisters, to look at the current events and things that are coming up before our church families. We look at the current events. Wexit all 2021 college graduates are asked to submit their names and contact information to the church office. If you're a 2021 college graduate, please submit your name and contact information to our church office. Now remember, report cards are due now for the third marking period. Report cards are due. The deadline is this Tuesday, May 11th at 5 o'clock p.m. All report cards that were mailed in or emailed, we're going to take them out of the box on this Tuesday, and then we will place those and give those to the educational committee, and that will be the final deadline for report cards. Please, ma'am, and please, sir, again, I say to you, if our young people have been at home working diligently, some have been virtual, some have been virtual and in person, some have been in person, whatever the method has been, if they have made the honor roll, please, ma'am, please, sir, make sure you get that information in. The greatest joy is to see how proud a child feels when they are recognized for something that they have achieved. Amen?
Amen.
So please, ma'am, and please, sir, do so. If you go email or send it to our church at info@centralbaptistcolumbia.org. Thank you so much. We want to remind you that CES is partnering with our church family to administer vaccines here at our church on May the 17th, as well as June the 14th for the second dosage. And all you have to do is go to our website and pull the information and follow the link that is given to you right there. With that link, you'll be able to get in directly to schedule your appointment. We want to do what we can within our community to help as much as we possibly can. If we only had one person that was vaccinated, that's one more person that has protected themselves. Amen?
Amen.
So we want to be in the community but actually involved in what's going on around us. So you can go to our website, call the church office if you have a problem getting through with the link, but we want to serve and accommodate you. Now, you can call the church office if you want to be included with the text message, the email message from Groupcast that we sent out. So if you did not receive it or you want to make sure your name is on there, please call the church office. We have a new communication system we put in place. I think you will totally enjoy it once it's complete, because it's going to include our website, it's going to include our Instagram, all the social media is going to be tied in it as well. It's first class, upscale, uptown, y'all. We didn't miss anything on this one. So call the church office and say, do you have me down? They're going to ask you, well, make sure we have the right telephone number and the right text number, and everything else will fall into place. Thank you for what you're going to do in advance. And let me remind you, my brothers and sisters, that this week at our church, beginning Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, we would host a Gethsemane Women's Auxiliary Annual Session. It'll begin each night at 6:30. It'll be virtually broadcast. Each night at 6:30, all you have to do is go to our website on the centralbaptistcolumbia.org or follow us on YouTube, follow us on Facebook. We're going to virtually broadcast it for all the Women's Auxiliary, and we're excited about hosting them this week. But all the people being in participation with those on program will be at the church. Everything else will be virtually broadcast. So we're looking forward to doing all we possibly can. Amen?
Amen.
God is awesome, God, and we thank him for everything that he has done and what God is doing. Amen. Amen. Let us prepare to give back to God a portion of that which the Lord has blessed us with. Amen. As we prepare to give, let us prepare to give back to God a portion of that which the Lord has blessed us with. prior to lifting the offering, if this is your first time as a visitor here at the Central Baptist Church, stand right where you are. If this is your first time worshiping with us, will you stand right where you are? Good morning, Central. Amen. Let us stand and prepare to give back to God a portion of that which He has blessed us with. God, our Father, thank you for this opportunity to give back to you your tithes and our offering. We want to be obedient to your word to bring your tithes and offering into the storehouse, that you would open up the windows of heaven and pour us a blessing that we don't have room enough to receive. God, we stand in need of that kind of blessing right now. Somebody been struggling all week long. Somebody been stressed out all week long, wondering how they're going to make it, how they're going to get through this situation. As believers, we walk by faith and not by sight. We learn how to take it out of our hands, put it in the Lord's hand, and believe and trust that the Lord will make a way somehow. Thank you for this opportunity to give back to you a portion of what you bless us with. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Outside face a wall, inside face each other. Follow the direction of our choir. As they lead us in music, as they usher, give you direction for God.
Somebody of Gethsemane, he took the time. Oh, I'm glad that he prayed. Oh, yes, I am. I'm so glad. Oh, somebody prayed. Are you glad they are? Are you glad they pray? Oh, wow. Are you so glad? Are you so glad? Are you so glad they pray for me? Thank you. Amen. If I could only hear my mother pray again. If I could only hear her tender voice again, said how happy, Lord, I would be.
You better say so.
It means so much to me. If I could hear my mother pray again. Come on, everybody, say it. If I could only hear my mother
pray again,
if
I could only hear
her tender
voice again,
how happy I would be, y'all. It means so much. If I could hear my
voice,
said if I could only hear my mother pray. Her tender voice again. How happy I would be, y'all. It means so much to me. If I could hear my mother pray, oh, if I could only my mother pray, if I could only hear her tender voice again, how happy I would be. It means so much to me. If I could hear my mother pray, if I could hear my mother pray, if I could hear my mother again.
The Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 20, verses 20 through 23. The Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 20, verse 20 through 23. Verse 20 reads as follows. Then came to him is Jesus, the mother of Zebedee's children with her sons, worshiping him and desiring a certain thing of him. This is a mother. The mother has sons. So it qualifies for a Mother's Day message. All right, and said that she desired a certain thing of him. And he said unto her, what wilt thou? She said unto him, grant that these my two sons may sit one on the right hand and the other on the left in thy kingdom. Some people have been hard on Salome, the mother of Zebedee's children, because they said she made this bold step to ask the Lord to grant favor to her children. As old young folks say, I ain't mad at her. Every mama at some times has made petitions before the Lord on behalf of their children. But Jesus answered and said, you know not what you ask. Are you able to drink of the cup that I shall drink of and be baptized with the baptism that I'm baptized with? They said unto him, we are able. And he said unto them, ye shall drink indeed of my cup and be baptized with the baptism I'm baptized with. But to sit on my right hand and on my left hand, I like what his answer was. He said, it is not mine to give, but it shall be for them who is prepared for my Father. I just want to tag it from what the response was. This response was, it is not mine to give. You may be seated. I know it feels like spiritual exercise for a minute. Will all mothers please stand? Happy Mother's Day to each and every, should I say, with a church stand? Happy Mother's Day to each and every one of you. Let's give our mothers a wonderful hand. Thank God for all mothers. Amen. Amen. We thank God for each and every one of you. Mothers, there's a time when we lift up all womanhood. I say that we lift up all women on this day, not only those who are specifically mothers, because all women have shared in the responsibility of mothering black people. Our mothers have not only been those who have been born with their own children, our mothers have been older sisters who have raised the family when death or some other circumstances took natural mothers away. Our mothers have been grandmothers far beyond their childbearing years and aunts, some of whom never had children but raised other folks' children. Our mothers have been relatives and friends of our family who have taken children under their wing. Our mothers have been persons of compassion who served as foster parents and who accepted those with whom the major connecting link was not biological. Our mothers have been teachers, some of whom did not have their own children, but who served as role models and taught us so much about kindness and character. Our mothers have been women of the church who thought enough of us to work with us, correct us when we were wrong, encourage us when we were downcast, and pray for us when we did not realize it. Oh, how special are mothers in the African-American community. Mothers is especially significant in the black community because of our history. Motherhood on these shores began in the dark and dreary backdrop of slavery. From the onset, slavery was designed to disrupt the stable black family. Can I say that again? On the outset, slavery was designed to disrupt the stable black family. One parent family became all too characteristic of our history. And more time than we can admit that one parent was a mother. God gave them a double portion of patience and grace and dreams and hopes and strength to determine to make life better for their children. I think that's every mother's prayer, to make life better for their children. There's no mother like a black mother. My brothers and sisters, you gotta be careful, and we understand and realize in this society, we don't need song berating women who are mothers in our society. Remember, you don't answer to the B word, you ain't nobody B. Don't play with me this morning now. You don't answer to the W word. Do you hear me? No matter what people say about you, don't you let that define you. What you got to declare, say what you want to say about me, but I'm going to be a faithful mother to the child that God has blessed me to raise. Do I have a witness in here? I wish I had a prayer in church. Well, I want you to understand, my brothers and sisters, that many times it's not what we say, but many times it is how we say it. This mother was making a request. See, I don't know about you, but I was raised in Georgia. You may have been raised in North Carolina. Somebody's in Florida, other parts of the states, all over. But I think growing up, we all shared common experiences. Can I talk about some of the common experience? You've been raised by a black mother. You've been hit with an extension call. Can I just talk about common experience? You've been hit with a switch or a shoe. You had to go pick your own switch off the tree and sent you back. And you know what we would do back then, right? We'd try to get the smallest switch we could. And guess what they'll do? Make you go get another one and tie them together. Oh, I wish I had a praying church in here today. You were raised by a black mother when she used to say to you, don't you leave this house and go out there and act like you don't have no home training. Do I have a witness in there? You raised by a black mother, she made sure when you left there, what you had underneath your clothes was clean. Huh? In other words, she would tell you, you could be in a car accident, you could get sick, something happened to you, and you ain't gonna embarrass our family having holes in your underwear and holes in your... You were raised by a black mother, if you suck your teeth at your own risk. You were raised by a black mother, if you had a degree in duckology, you learned how to duck at an early age. You were raised by a black mother, you were scared to go home if you got a bad grade. You were raised by a black mother, in our house, I never heard words like time out or you are grounded. In the bathroom, there was always a supply of alcohol, peroxide, cocoa butter, cod liver oil, Vaseline were the main items in the cabinet. Do I have a witness in here? You were never grounded, you were just beat down. You were raised by a black mother, you've been pinched for going to sleep in church. You were raised by a black mother, she made you participate in every church activity they had. You own the little choir, the junior choir, the junior usher, Eastern Christmas play, tiny tot choir, you name it. If the church had it, you own it. You were raised by a black mother. You've been told to turn off that TV, get off that phone, and sit down and be quiet because it's storming outside. When it's storming outside, the Lord is talking. You were raised by a black mother. She had to pray, Lord, please don't let me hurt this child. Do I have a witness in here? My brothers and my sisters, she made a request, but the Lord reminded her, it is not mine to give. As the disciples followed Jesus toward Jerusalem, they knew he believed he would die. He had told them on three different occasions what was to become of his kingdom, who would be in charge after his death. Among themselves, the disciples were arguing about this issue. For the third time, Jesus announced his arrest, crucifixion, and resurrection. In the previous announcement, he had not specified how he would die, but now he clearly mentioned the cross. He also clearly mentioned his resurrection, but the message did not penetrate the hearts of the disciples. In contrast to this announcement of suffering and death, we have the request of James and John and their mother, Salome. Jesus spoke about a cross, but they were more interested in a crown. They wanted reserved seats on special throne. We get the impression that the mother Salome was the real inspiration behind the request. Mothers, can I tell you, be careful trying to push your children up too soon. Be careful of trying to push them to an area that God doesn't have an anointing for them in their life. Do I have a witness in him? And the truth of that falls really hard sometimes on preachers and preachers' children. Just because the pastor has been called to preach does not mean that his sons have necessarily been called to preach. All you want them to be is to find young men and find something in life they enjoy and find something they have a passion for. You don't want to push them into an area because everybody else say they're supposed to be in that area. My brothers and sisters, we got to be careful on self-promotion. But the text said, then came to him the mother of Zebedee's children with her son worshiping him and his eye on a certain thing of him. At least she had enough sense to be worshiping. And he said unto her, what wilt thou? She said unto him, grant that these my two sons may sit, one on the right hand and the other on the left hand in their kingdom. But Jesus answered and said, you know not what you ask. Are you able to drink of the cup that I shall drink of and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with? They say unto him, we are able. And he said unto them, ye shall drink indeed of my cup, and be baptized with the baptism I'm baptized with. But to sit on my right hand, and to sit on my left hand, he said, it is not mine to give, but it shall be for them who is prepared of the Father.
Well, first of all, there are three insights I want to leave you with today. Now, I'll be out of your way. First of all, I want to look at the devotion of this mother. For the text said, then came to him the mother Zebedee, children with her sons, James and John, and she was worshiping him, and she desired a certain thing of him. Three people were involved in this petition. They were two of the best disciples, James and John, and their mother. All three represented holy character, high standards, and yet pride infected their life. You do not have to be a godless vow sinner to have trouble with pride. Ah, the best of saints, you better hear me loud and clear, can be tempted by pride also. That a mother should encourage this petition of pride makes the petition even more worse. Many mothers and fathers also in every age have caused many problems by trying to get their children in the high position. If they're supposed to be there, then the Lord will promote them there himself. Do I have a witness in here? I've learned a long time ago that whatever God has for me, that it is for me. Do I have a witness in here? I learned I don't have to scheme. I don't have to backstab. I don't have to manipulate. I don't have to use folk. I don't have to abuse folk. I don't have to talk down to folks. Because my mama reminded me, the same folks you meet on your way up the ladder, you're going to have to meet those same folks on your way back down the ladder. And the same folks you turn your nose up to, one day you may have to bow down your knees to them. For I've learned how to treat everybody. Do I have a witness in here? I may not have what you have. I may not live where you live. I may not drive what you drive. But I'm still somebody. I'm still a child of the King. Do I have a witness in here? Do I have anybody that's grateful in here? Do I have anybody that's thankful in here? Do I have anybody that had a praying mama that would be down on her knees praying while we were out in the streets doing anything that we wanted to do? I'm so glad that somebody prayed for me. I'm so glad that somebody had me on their mind. I'm so glad I had a praying mama, a praying big mama, a praying nana, that somebody prayed for me. We've had parents, mothers who push and shove and pull strings to get their children in prestigious schools or jobs or the positions of esteem. I'm not saying don't open a door for your child. Do it the right way. Huh? Do it the right way. They need instead to be earnest about their children's character. Character is more important than any position. Character is more important than any position. When you look in the mirror, what do you see? Are you proud of the reflection that's staring back at you? When Jesus was crucified, Salome was one of the persons standing near the cross and sharing his sorrow and pain. She did not see two thrones on either side of the Lord, but she saw two thieves on two crosses. And she heard Jesus give her son John to his mother Mary. Then the mother of James and John came to ask a favor of Jesus. She was apparently among Jesus' regular followers who were not part of the 12. She was at the cross when Jesus was crucified. Some had suggested that she was the sister Mary, the mother of Jesus. Thus, she and her sons may have hoped that their close family relationship would lend weight to their request. Be careful of letting too many folks get too close to you. I'm not saying be standoffish and be arrogant, don't want to have nothing to do with anybody. But you can't let some folks get so close to your heart that they'll hear your heartbeat. Because they may have a hidden agenda. And also, when the Lord blesses your children are doing well, don't expect everybody to celebrate with you. Huh? Don't expect everybody to celebrate with you. Because it's hard for somebody to celebrate your child if their child is struggling. It takes a strong Christian to walk by faith and not by sight to be able to rejoice off the fact your child just got a scholarship and their child just got denied entrance in school. But it doesn't matter if you got denied. God denies are not necessary. God's delays. You just got to be patient and wait on the Lord. Also, James and John, who were a brother along with Peter, made up the inner circle of disciples. So Salome's two sons with Peter have already been treated with special distinction at the raising of Jairus' daughter and at the transfiguration, and this might encourage their high ambition. They had high ambition based on the way that they have already been treated. But this woman was devoted to her children. And she came worshiping before the Lord. We looked at her devotion. Now let's look at her demand. 20 and 21 said, and he said unto her, what wilt thou? In other words, the Lord said, I know you want some. Yeah. Sometimes folks come around you, they've been around you, playing up to you, smiling with you, asking, what wilt thou? I mean, what is it that you want? I knew it, so we ain't got to go back 20 years from high school and talk about those days. What wilt thou? She said unto him, grant that these my two sons may sit, one at the right hand and the other on the left in thy kingdom. Well, in ancient warrior courts, a person chosen to sit at the right and the left hand of the king were highly honored. James and John's mother wanted her sons to sit beside Christ in the most honored place in the kingdom. They all understood that Jesus would have a kingdom. However, until after the resurrection, none of them fully understood that Jesus' kingdom was not of this world. It was not centered in palace and thrones, but in the hearts and lives of his followers. There's nothing wrong with high position of responsibility and authority. Leadership and organization, government and law, teachers and learners, parents and child, all are essential. However, all positions should exist not to lord over people, but to serve people. We are to seek to serve people, not seek to rule people. Our ambition should not be to lead, but to serve. This was James and John's era. It is often ours. There's a tremendous difference between leading and serving. But Jesus answered and said, you know not what you ask. Are you able to drink of the cup that I should drink of? Be baptized with the baptism that I'm baptized with? They said unto him, we are able. Jesus responded to making such a self-centered request. They did not know what they were asking. To request position of high honor means also to request deep suffering. You can't have high honor without deep suffering. They come together. For instance, you know, there's no such thing. I tell people all the time, they say to you, well, I wish you good luck. Believers don't go by luck. Huh? Huh? If you want to have success, the best definition I read of success was an operation and preparation, opportunity and preparation meet. That's the best bet. When opportunity and preparation meet, then success will come. You gotta have the opportunity, but you must be prepared. They said some people miss success because success comes disguised in overalls dressed as work. Did you get that? And so my brothers and sisters, they cannot have one without the other. You can't have the crown without the cross. Jesus asked first, are they able to drink from the bitter cup? And we must be willing, if we want to glory, suffer with him, we would also someday glorify with him. That's good news, my brothers and my sisters. As I press sort of close now, I just want to remind you that Jesus said that it's not mine to give. Do I have a witness in here? We looked at the devotion of this mother. We looked at the demand that she had made. Now we must look at the denial that she received. God doesn't grant us everything that we ask for. Some things God has to deny us for right now in order to prepare us for greater things that are about to come up. Do I have a witness in here? For God is still able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we ask or think, according to the power that worketh within us. Do I have a witness in here? He said, it is not mine to give up. And that's good news, my brothers and my sister. I'm glad that the Lord doesn't grant me everything that I ask for, but I'm glad that he will meet me and supply me at my point of need. Do I have a witness in here? Well, I wish I had a prayer in church right now. Well, I'm saying that some mother who's gathered here today, just keep your hand in the Lord's hand and abide by his command and watch and see what the Lord will do. I'll tell him you can talk about me as much as you please, but the more you talk, I'm going down on my bending knees. Tell him I had my share of struggles, and I had to cry sometimes. Tell him, yes, I've been back and forth in church. There were many Sundays I wore the same bottom, but I just had a different top. Do I have a witness in here? You got to use what you have and give God the praise and give God the glory. Do I have a praying church in here? God is still able. Whenever God says no, look for God's instead. God never says no without a substitute of instead. He'll give you another blessing. He'll give you another answer. He'll give you another revelation. He'll give you another resolution. See, God said no to Moses. You will not enter the promised land. But instead, he said, I will transport you across the barrier of time, put you on the snow-kissed crest of Mount Hermon to get a panoramic view of that land that's flowing with milk and honey. Well, you won't be able to go in yourself, but I still would allow you to see the promised land. When God tells you no, look for God, yes, instead. When David's son, Bathsheba, was stricken with illness and David prayed and fasted for the child's Lord life, God said no to David's prayer and the child died. But later Bathsheba was pregnant again and God said yes, and Solomon was born. God said no to Paul when he wanted the thorn removed from his flesh, but later on he said yes, cause my grace is sufficient. My strength is made perfect in the midst of our weakness. Do I have a witness in there? There are times that God will close one door just to open another door. When God says no, we must learn to walk by faith and not by sight. We must declare like Job said, that though he slay me, yet will I trust him. All the days of my appointed time, I'ma wait until my change come. God will supply all of my needs. God promised that the just shall live by faith, and the wicked shall cease from troubling. God promised, when you come through the waters, I'll be with you. When you go through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, thou shalt not be burned. Do I have a witness in here? I want to remind some mother here that God will. He'll take care of you. Don't seek any power yourself. He said, it is not mine to give. Do I have a witness in here? God will take care of you. You don't understand why your loved ones have died, but God will take care of you. You don't understand why you lost your job, but can I get a witness in here that God, I said God, he will take care of you. You can't understand while your children have gone astray. But his word is said, I've been young, but now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsake, nor see begging bread. You don't know where the money's coming from in order to pay your bills. But do I have a witness in here that the God we serve, he will? I said he will. Do I have a mother in here who's a living witness? When you look back over your life and all the mess you've been through, all the hell you've been through, all the struggles you dealt with, do I have a witness in here that God will? I said he will. He'll take care of you. If you know God will, just throw your hand up in the air and tell the Lord, thank you. For this is the day that the Lord had made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I need some mothers in here, some African-American sisters in here who don't mind praising God. You didn't raise that child all by yourself. I hear all this crazy talk. I just had a man, he was a sperm bank. He ain't do nothing but leave a sperm. But God took care of you, and God took care of your child. It wasn't the child support that kept you. Do I have anybody here that can look back over your life? I need some grateful mothers in here. Some mothers who didn't have it all together. Some mothers who messed up along the way. Some mothers who fallen short along the way. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Come on in here. It's not mine to give, but what I have, I can give. I can give you my best praise. Come on, mothers in here. It doesn't matter who you are. God raised that child. God kept you healthy. God kept you on that job. It was nobody. Shout nobody. Shout nobody. Shout nobody. Shout nobody, shout nobody, shout nobody, shout nobody, shout nobody. It was nobody but the Lord. It is not mine to give. You don't know what you're asking. It is not mine to give. She was devoted. Wasn't like she didn't love the Lord. She made a demand, and God had to deny her request because it was not in her best interest. Sometimes we ask things of the Lord that's not in our best interest. Some of the saddest relationships are people who've been together for a while because it's physical. If all you see is a physical part of a relationship, you're in deep trouble. During the early days, you want her to be fine. God knows you do. You don't be going nowhere with no bow wall on y'all. You want her to be fine. But as you grow and you mature in life and y'all grow together, I'm going to tell you, the fineness will leave her in you. Then you'll want to know what's really keeping us together. Then you value the person and not look at her as an object. I told you, you can get somebody fine and crazy. She's you're looking for a little house in the prairie, you got nightmare on Elm Street. My request upon the Lord, if it's according to your will, Lord, I receive what you have in store for me, for my families, for my son, for my wife, but it must line up with your will. Let us stand. It is not mine to give. This mama was just going over half of her children, but she went about it the wrong way. Ain't no sense in you asking God to help your child make her equal. They studied a leak. I know you have the power, Lord. And the Lord is whispering down, steady. Open your book. Help me help you. There may be someone up on the side of my voice this day. Want to step out from where you are. Give the pastor your hand, but give God your heart. You may come by letter, by your Christian experience, or a candidate for baptism. We serve a whosoever will God. Whosoever will, let them come. The door of the church is open. Will you come? Yes, yes. Will you come today? We're preparing for altar prayer. Maybe your mother's not physically here with you. Maybe they've transitioned from labor onto reward. If they've made that transition, live your life in a manner that will be pleasing to your mother. The best thing I can do for my mother is to be the best son I possibly could be. Be the best husband I possibly could be. Be the best father I could be, best pastor I could be, to make her proud of the sacrifices she's made. Y'all take me down a little bit, take me down a little bit. The sacrifices she's made. I watched this woman work in the lunchroom at the school all during the week, but go scrub or clean other folks' bathrooms and clean houses on the weekend. So I would have a chance to go to college. You can't forget those sacrifices. I could never get so big or think I'm so high that I don't remember seeing her coming in, knees hurting, sore from working all day and clean up, just so I can go walk across the stage and say I was a college graduate in our family. Don't you get so big at it wherever you are. You think you're above mama because she don't speak well, because she don't look dressed like other folks dress, because she's not a professional. She was professional enough to raise you. Professional enough to raise me. Well, I was just as crazy as I could be, man. I wasn't buck wild, but I was in between. You hear me? And she still prayed for me. I come home from school broke. I had no money. Mama struggled. I go to mama, tell her what I need, and mama go. In the bank, y'all. And had it tied in double knots. And knew how to untie it right there. I never forget the sacrifices. My sister Annalee called me the other day from Georgia. Said her house had burned out. Lost everything that she had. The only sister I have remaining, my other sister Frances, passed away. She called me. She said, Rick, I lost everything that I had. I don't have anything. I said two words to you. I said, I got you.
Amen.
I got you. You go find out what you need. I got you. That's what my mama want me to do. I got to be the best brother to my sister now, because that's what family does. There ain't no time to talk about who started the fire, there was what the plug hot. That ain't got nothing. She done lost everything she had. She's reaching out. My response was to be there for her. Mom on a dying bed grabbed my hand and said, look out for your sisters. I heard a voice when my sister called. My mama said, look out for your sister. I'm going to honor her request until there's no breath that's left in my body. Pastor Freddie Smith, will you lead us in prayer, please, sir?
Let us pray. Gracious Father, we thank you for blessing us to live again. Thank you, Lord, for endowing us with your free spirit. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us today with a word, with manna that came from on high. Thank you, Lord, that reminds us, Lord, that help us, Lord, to honor our mothers. Every day is Mother's Day. As we pause on this day to thank you for our mothers and to go down memory lane and to see the things that they've done so that we could get where we need to be. One thing, Lord, thank you, Lord, that our mothers told us about a Messiah. A God who sits high, but he looks low. He's endowed with grace and mercy. Thank you, God, for that mother that prayed for us, walked the floor all night long sometime. Knees were sorely from kneeling on that bedside, cooking food and singing songs while she's cooking food and washing our clothes in our old washing board on the back and putting our clothes on the clothesline. Making that sweet cornbread. But also, Lord, putting us in check when it was time to do so. Telling us right from wrong when it was time to do so. Thank you for a mother's love that resembles God's love. Thank you, Lord, for blessings all over the world. Thank you, Lord, for how you bless your people to walk upright and to be a person of integrity. Even when the world laughs at you, there's a God who is proud of you because you kept your dignity in him. Thank you, Lord, for this word, Lord, that's not only just for just recognizing mothers, but, Lord, just recognizing the contributions that they paid, not just to society, but it started at home. Thank you, Lord, for home. So that when we go out of our home, we will look like you because she got her direction from you. She got everything she needed from you. Thank you, Lord, for the word that came today and it caused us to reflect on just how good you are and that you are not a God who's respecter of persons. You don't play favorites, but you love us all one and the same. And you've got blessings for everyone. And Lord, it's so personal that it's got our name on it. But forgive us, Lord, when we go astray. Forgive us when we do wrong. And even in this pandemic, Lord, we pray that you are proud of us for something we did or something that we said to make somebody's life just a little bit easier. And it resembles a mother's love. Thank you, Lord, for blessing us with your word today, that when times get a little rough, times get a little tough, we got something that we can do like a cow. We can bring it back up and chew on it again, because your word will be here when heaven and earth passes away. We need your eternal word. When day seems like night, night seems like day, we got something we can stand on. We got something we can lean on. We got something we can put our all in all on, Jesus. And that's your word. Again, heaven and earth will fade away, but your word will forever stand. Thank you, Lord, for leading us to the rock that is higher than I. Thank you, Lord, for these prayers and many other blessings. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Let us remain standing. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you to lift up his countenance and give you peace henceforth, now and forever. Enjoy your Mother's Day. Have a happy Mother's Day. Enjoy your day.